إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، Verily all praise and glory is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is due to Him and none other. We praise Him and we seek His forgiveness and we ask Him for His mercy. And we testify in His state that there is no God or deity worthy of any type of worship but Allah. And that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a servant and final messenger. O ye who believe, fear Allah, the fear that He is most deserving of you. And do not die unless you are in the state of al-Islam. And ask what follows. The topic that I will be addressing you with today is a subject that wallah, for many, many months, even years, I have been wishing to discuss with you. And I have been asked many times by Muslim brothers and Muslim sisters to speak about this topic. Although as soon as you hear the topic, you may think that this is a topic dealing only with a woman's issue. But in fact, it is something that can be considered a cornerstone in the building of a clean, pure, Islamic, righteous life and existence. The topic is al-hijab, the Muslim woman's covering, the dignity that Allah has bestowed upon our Muslim women, to raise them, to give them self-respect, self-honor, self-esteem, self-confidence, to give them what they truly deserve for worshipping Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a ibadah. It is a worship of Allah. Wearing hijab, it is ibadah. It is a worship of Allah. For as we know, al-ibadah ismun jami'. Worshipping Allah is a general term for anything that you do that Allah loves, whether it is a statement or an action or a belief in your heart. And in order to focus in this large topic, we will focus our attention to four main points. First, لماذا حجاب? Why? Why wear hijab? ثانيا, من الذي أمر? Who is the one that has ordered to wear hijab? ثالثا, شروط الحجاب الشرعي. The requirements that must, and I stress it again, the requirements that must be fulfilled for the Muslim woman to truly be in a state of hijab. And they are seven in number. And fourth and finally, الأسباب التي تؤدي إلى خلع الحجاب والرد عليه. Reasons why women, Muslim women, may not wear hijab and how we answer them and advise them and support them and call them to the purity of covering. So let us begin with the first of our important points. لماذا? Why? I will give you only two of the many, many points. Further, because Allah told you so. And if that was it, if this was the only reason, it is enough. فَيَكْفِي Allah الخالق البارئ المصور The one who has created, innovated, sustained life, sustained you, provides for you, who has created you. وَهُوَ أَدْرَى بِخَلْقِهِ And he knows what is best for his creation. Has decreed that you are to wear hijab. أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ Does he, Allah says in Surah Al-Mulk, the one who has created Allah, not know what is best for his creation? And he is the most kind and well aware. The second reason is because the shaitan wants you to take it off. And we are ordered by Allah to disobey the shaitan. استحوذ عليهم الشيطان فأنساهم ذكر الله The shaitan came into them, influenced them until he made them forget totally the remembrance of Allah, the worship of Allah. How and why does the shaitan do this? From the first day, the shaitan met our father and mother, Adam and Hawa, Adam and Eve, he intended to remove their coverings and garments. Listen in Surah Al-A'raf, verse number 27. يَا بَنِي آدَمُ O children of Adam, a warning to us. لَا يَفْتِنَنَّكُمْ شَيْطَانِ Let not the shaitan deceive you. Had he deceived your parents? كَمَا أَخْرَجَ أَبَوَيْكُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ Had he deceived your parents? Caused them to be forced out of paradise. How and why? يَنْزِعُ عَنْهُمَا لِبَاسَهُمَا By removing their covering. لِيُرِيَهُمَا سَوْآتِهِمَا To expose and to lay bare their private parts. وَا إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيرُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُ For he, the shaitan, Satan, the devil, and his people see you from a place where you do not see them. إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا الشَّيَاطِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ And Allah says, we have caused the shaitan to be a friend and a protector of those who have no belief. So this is why you wear hijab. Now we move to our second point, to verify that it is Allah who ordered you to wear a hijab, a Muslim sister. And wallah, I am speaking to you from my heart, not my lips. It is from my heart that I speak to you today. Why hijab? Who ordered it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He tells us in Surah An-Nur, speaking first to you and me, the men. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ Tell the believing men. يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُ فُرُوجَهُمْ Tell the men to lower their gaze, look away. Do not stare at what is prohibited. Turn, avert your gaze. And guard their private parts and their modesty. فَجَعَلَ رَقْضِ النَّظَرِ سَبَبًا رَئِيْسِيًّا لِحِبِّ الْفَرْجِ So Allah means that by protecting your sight and looking away, you will protect your private parts, you will not fall into sin. And now we hear and we read from the psychologists where they say two main things influence the man, excite him. Two things. First is looking. A person can be given a picture, a man given a picture, without hearing a single word. Just looking at it becomes excited. And the second is by touching something. So Allah tells you, do not look. And if you do not look, you will guard your private parts. ذَٰلِكَ أَذْكَى لَهُمْ This is purer, cleaner, better for them. And Allah knows وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ Allah is well aware of all that they do. But then Allah addresses the Muslim woman. فَهِيَ مَحَلُّ الشَّهْوَةِ For she is the object of desire. وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ And let us pause here. Tell the believing women. Allah does not say, tell the Muslim women. He says, tell the believing women. لِأَنَّ الْمَرْأَةِ Because the woman, if she does not put hijab, Although she believes in Allah, she will never, ever reach fullness in belief. She's Muslim. She will enter the Jannah, insha'Allah. If Allah wishes to punish her, He may do so. And if Allah wishes to forgive her, He may do so. But she will never be considered a true believer. كل المؤمنات يغضبن من أبصارهن ويحفظن فروجهن. Tell them to also lower their gaze and to guard their private parts. But an increasing statement. ولا يبدين زينتهن. But let them cover up and not show their adornment and beauty. ولا يبدين زينتهن إلا ما ظهر منها. Except that which must naturally be laid bare, must naturally be shown. وليضربن بخمرهن على جيوبهن. And let them hang. Al-khimar is a garment that hangs from the top of the head, hangs down, covers the neck, and covers the bosom. يبنين. Let them cover themselves with this garment. And then Allah reminds again and says, and let them not show their private parts, let them not show their beauty. Illa, except, only 12 groups of people. Illa لبعولتهم, for husbands. And the husband has all the right to see every part of the Muslim woman. Ask the Muslim woman, her husband, as she has the right to see every part of her husband's body. Then the next group of people, they may only see the Muslim woman in the latter state of hijab. She must be covered from the navel to the knee. For example, she may breastfeed in front of the rest of the people. أو آبائهم, her father. أو آبائهم, the father of her husband. أو أبنائهم, or her son. أو أبناء بعولتهن, or the sons of her husband, her stepson. أو إخوانهن, or her brothers. أو بني إخوانهن, or the sons of her brother. أو بني أخواتهن, or the sons of her sister. أو نسائهن, or her Muslim female friends. أو ما ملكت أيمانهن, or her female servants who are under her. أو التابعين غير أولي الإربة من الرجال. Or the male servant who is under her, who has lost all sexual acts. The last one. Or the young child, الذين لم يصروا على عورات النساء, who no longer, or who has not yet been given the ability to differentiate between the sexes, that does not understand the feminine sex. And then Allah says, وَلَا يَضْرِبْنَ بِأَرْجُلِهِمْ لِيُعْلَمَ مَا يُخْفِينَ مِنْ زِينَتِهِنَّ. And let not these respectable Muslim women stamp their foot so as to expose or to show or to draw attention to that which may be hidden of their beauty under their garments. And then Allah concludes these two verses by saying, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. And repent to Allah. Allah knows that you will commit sin. Allah knows that you will transgress. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. All of you, أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, all of you believers, men and women, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. If you wish to attain success. And know, my Muslim sister, that if you hear from this day or whenever you hear this tape, and you begin to dress in the Islamic clothing that we will soon describe to you what it is, know that all the days that you did not dress will be changed into days that you were dressing in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Except for those who repent and believe. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. Repent and believe and work righteous deeds. For them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall take their evil deeds and change them into righteous deeds. And Allah is the most forgiving and the most merciful. Also, we find in the Quran in Surah Al-Ahzab, verse number 59, the verses that I just recited to you were from Surah Al-Nur, the chapter of light, verse 29 and 30. In Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah makes a clear, decisive order to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ayyuhan nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O Prophet of Allah, قل لأزواج, tell your wife, Christ, personal. Motherhood, also personal. Again, mu'mineen. And all of the women who have belief, or the women of the believers. What should he tell them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? يُدْنِينَ عَلَيْهِنَّ مِنْ جَلَابِيبِهِمْ. Let them cover themselves with a jilbab, an outer garment. Something that is worn over their clothing. ذَلِكَ أَدْنَى أَنْ يُعَرَفْنِ فَلَا يُعْدَيْنِ. In so doing, they will be known as free, respectable Muslim women who are not to be annoyed or molested. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Again, Allah ends the verse with mercy and forgiveness. And Allah is the most forgiving and the most merciful. A direct order from Allah to His Prophet to advise and to order us, our Muslim wives and women, to cover in the purity of hijab. This brings us to our third point. What is hijab? Is it just anything you put on wearing hijab? It does not matter what madhab or what school of thought you are thinking. All of them have the same seven basic points. Many of the madhab add to them. But these seven must be fulfilled. Doesn't matter who you follow. A woman, covering all of the body except that which is permitted to be shown. The weakest or the lowest state of hijab is that she must cover all her body except her hands and her face. Even the feet, as the Rasulullah said in the authentic hadith in Tirmidhi, let them be covered. Except for the hands and the face. Second. The clothes you wear, it is not in its point and form to be something to attract attention to you. Something that people look at you and want to come and talk to you because you are wearing. So it cannot be a clothing that beautifies you more. It is something that is to give you more humility in the sight of Allah and mankind. That the clothing is to be thick or meaning that you cannot see through it. You can't see through the clothing. You can't tell what color her skin is. رابعاً that it is to be wide, encompassing, full, meaning as all of the consensus, ijma' al-ulama. Never will a scholar stand and say that a Muslim woman is permitted to wear a pair of shorts or trousers or jeans unless she is covering over it with something. Never. Therefore, you must have something that covers over your clothing. Number five, that the clothing or the body itself cannot have any trace of perfume. Something that if she walks by, you can smell it. As the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the authentic hadith in Abu Dawood and Tirmidhi, if a Muslim woman leaves her house and her clothing or her body has a scent, a perfume to it, and she passes by a group of men, and they can smell it, she has committed such and such with them. She has called them to adultery, called them to zina. This is the gravity of the situation, ibadallah. Number six, that the clothing should not ever be the same as the clothing that is known exclusively for males. For Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ. Allah shall send His curse. Allah shall send His anger. Allah shall send His wrath upon the man who who dresses in clothing of women, and women who dress in the clothing of men, and the hadith is sahih. And seventh and finally, from the requirement, Allah yushbih libas al-kafirat, it is not to be similar to the clothing of the disbelieving women. We move now quickly to our fourth and final point, because there is something important that I wish to discuss with you after Jinsat al-Istiraha. Our fourth and final point, my brothers and sisters, the reason why some of our Muslim sisters and women do not wear hijab, and how we answer them in life. The main reason is other people. Whether it is because they are afraid of discrimination, losing their job, criticism, racism, being made fun of, not being cool, or it's because they are trying to impress someone, wanting to cave into the peer pressure. So we answer our Muslim sisters by saying, know for a fact that no one on the face of this earth has control over you. You, no one controls you. You are not going to lose your job because you wear hijab. If Allah wills, you will lose your job before you put the hijab on. I will give you a clear example so that you know that Allah is the one who is in full control. Allahu ghalibun ala amri. Look at the leader of the free world, the president of the United States of America, a man who is the most powerful socially, economically, politically, militarily. He bombed two of our Muslim countries on two different continents, in two different time zones, two different ships used, firing more than 100 missiles. Smart bomb, as they call it, with the push of a button and his signature on a piece of paper. Yet, he cannot push the harm from himself. A 25-year-old woman brought this wrath on him. Can't save himself every day. A new joke, a new article. People telling him, leave your office. You are no longer fit. Yet, he has the ability to bomb, and to destroy, and to cripple pharmaceutical plants. Do all that he will. Yet, he does not have the power to push the evil from himself. Know that no one has power over you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be afraid of no one. For Allah is your creator, and he is the one who sustains your life. And if Allah wills in a second to remove you from this earth, he will do so. The second thing I advise you with is know that you are not the first person to be made fun of or mocked because of your religion, the beautiful Islam. Allah depicts it in the Quran as we see it today, and we will remain seeing it until the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا كَانُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَتَّقُونَ. Those who committed crimes in the sight of Allah, the disbeliever, in this worldly life, when they saw a true believer, they used to laugh at him. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِهِمْ يَتَغَامَدُونَ. And when they walk by, they wink at one another, nudge one another, laughing at him. وَإِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمْ انْقَلَبُوا فَكِهِينَ. And when they return to their group, their gang, their tribe, their people, they return to them joking, look what we did to the Muslim, look how we made fun of her. وَإِذَا رَأَوْهُمْ. And when they see a mu'min, a mu'mina, one group in hijab, for example, قَالُوا إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَظَالِمُونَ. They say, these people are misguided. How are they dressed like this? Aren't they hot? What are they doing? And Allah answers, وَمَا أُرْسِلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ حَافِظِينَ. Allah tells them, we did not send you, O disbeliever, O criminal, in the sight of Allah, to watch over them and to watch everything they do. فَالْيَوْمِ. Allah says, on this day, the day of resurrection, الذين آمنوا من الكفار يضحكون.
Those who believe
shall be the ones laughing at the disbelief. على الأرائك ينظرون, sitting upon their thrones of light in the Jannah, looking at the disbelievers and laughing. And Allah ends by asking us a question. هل ثوب الكفار ما كانوا يفعلون. Have not the disbelievers now been paid fully for what they used to do to you? And the answer is yes. These are the words I leave you with, my brothers and sisters. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and to cover our Muslim sisters with the covering of humility, al-hijab, and to make it beloved to them in their hearts and in their minds and in their spirits. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in His blessing. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. I was asked to discuss with you an important point. For there today will be brothers who will be standing outside the masjid with the permission of the executive to collect some funds. And they will be handing you out some flyers, green ones and white ones like this. And I ask each and every one of you to not leave one of these brothers unless you have given him something. It is not going to him. It is not going to an organization. It is going to your brother and my brother. People who are struggling. People whose children are dying. Because they do not have food to feed them. Let me just read you some of the quotes of our brothers in Al-Iraq. Iraq, what is happening to them over there? 4,500 to 6,000 children die every month. 29%, a third of the children are malnutritious. Malnutrition affects, out of these 29, 7.5% severely acute malnutrition. 70% of the people cannot afford the basic needs of food. They cannot afford the basic essential needs to sustain themselves. And the last khutbah we spoke to you in this masjid about was knowing that we will be tested. Knowing that Allah shall test each and every one of us individually and collectively to see what we will do and how we will sustain our brothers and sisters with what Allah has given us. Also, in the country, it is now crippled, its water supply is decontaminated, the sanitation is almost non-existent, waterborne diseases are spreading throughout the land. Also, the animals that are being raised in the country, 60% of it is no longer existing. What they used to use to feed themselves, to plow the land, 60% is no longer there. I ask you once again by reminding you of the hadith of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ صَدَقَةَ السِّرِّ تُطْفِئُ غَضَبَ الرَّبِّ. Al-hadith Hassan rawahu al-Tabrani. To give sadaqa with no one knowing how much you've given, extinguishes the anger of Allah on you. I don't want to know what sins you or I have committed. Allah knows we all commit sins. But know that sadaqatu sirr tutfi'u ghadab Allah. Giving something in secret, no one knows the amount, shall extinguish Allah's anger on you. And also the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the authentic hadith in al-Tirmidhi, which is sahih, إن الصدقة تطفئ الخطيئة كما يطفئ الماء النار. Know that charity in the path of Allah extinguishes your sin as water extinguishes fire. And know ما نقص مال من صدقة. As is narrated in Sahih Muslim, never will your amount of money that you possess now be depleted or be lessened by you giving sadaqah from it. What you give, it hasn't left. it is actually going to be returned to you and many times more. These are the words I leave you with today. أَسْتَحْلِفُكُمْ بِاللَّهِ I ask you by Allah, and wallahi this is not fundraising. I ask you by Allah to not leave a single one of the brothers collecting unless you have given him something in the path of Allah. وَالْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ And know that your actions are judged according to their intentions. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا لا يرتد ونعيما لا ينفد وقرة عين لا تنقطع ومرافقة نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في جنات النعيم اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأقم الصلاة